We know from surveys conducted by the National Association of Realtors that, generally speaking, a seller will do business with the first real estate agent that they meet, like an 83% chance. It's pretty significant. So, oftentimes, sellers will not seek a second opinion, and that is a total mistake. And I want to give you an example of that. Last year, I sold a house. I was called in as a referral from someone I knew to give a listing consultation on a particular property. And I had spoken to Mr. and Mrs. Seller. We had talked about the property. I got some information on the house before I got there, square footage, upgrades they'd done, things like that. And I did my research. And my research, I work it a few different ways. I mean, I'm looking at comparables, but I'm also looking at HPI or the Home Price Index that Toronto Real Estate Board puts out. I'm looking at price per square foot, and I'm looking at, what my gut is telling me. So I went into this listing consultation with a number on their home. Now, they had already had another agent in there, and I didn't know that. So when I sat down at the table, we went through our marketing plan of action and what we do to get so many homes sold. And so we got to the part where we're talking about price. And so I explained my process and what I did. And in this case, what really supported this particular sale price for me was using a price per square foot method. And I wasn't seeing a comparable, especially once I got to see the house, I wasn't seeing a comparable that really, was directly comparable to this property. And so none of the other math kind of fit. We were in a bit of a busy market where, we were seeing some multiple offers on houses, but it wasn't necessarily on every house. And so, as it turned out, this particular house was a four bedroom, four bath, fully renovated, two car garage, over 2,500 square feet in Markham. So it was, in my opinion, I wanted to list it at $1,350,000. So, and I had used a price per square foot method to come up with that number. And I was convinced. I had done my research. I had pulled the not only the comparables, but I had pulled the square footage of all the most recent sales to sort of get an idea. And there was some consistency in the price per square foot that I was seeing in that area. So, as it turned out, the clients did list the house with me. Now, I was the agent out of the two. I was the agent that had the highest asking price or the highest list price. We know this sometimes in the market is called buying the listing, where someone, an agent, will go in and they will give you a number that's drastically higher than anybody else, but there's no support for it. It's just not supported in the market. There's no bearing in what's been happening in the market. In this case, I had some genuine data and math. I had like scribbled sheets of, work I had done on this house. So, I mean, it showed to the seller that I had done my homework. And at the end of the day, we ended up selling that house for 1.3 million in multiple offers. And here's the interesting part that the seller came back to me with after the fact. They didn't tell me this up front. The other agent that they were going to use thought that the house should be listed at 1,280, so 1,280,000. And she was just flabbergasted because she's like, had I have listed it for 1,280,000, I probably would have got under that. Seeing that we were listed at 1,350,000 and we got 1,300,000, she was just totally blown away by that. So, I mean, at the end of the day, I paid for my own commission. So, my advice to you as sellers out there is always seek a second opinion. I hope you found this helpful. Please feel free to reach out to me with any questions.